Welcome back to Game Over, guys.
Welcome back to Game Over, guys. It's Fallout Friday, and Brian's got candy in his face.
That's, yep, par for the course.
Drew's got chicken in his tum.
I have sharpened this candy cane and reversed it in my mouth so I can now stab Drew with it.
Oh, it's like some kind of shark attack.
Ew.
I was gonna go candy mosquito.
I ate too much. I'm gonna lay down.
Drew ate, like, one Drew's worth of chicken.
That was more than a Drew's worth.
Drew ate an entire chicken.
It's because you ate all of that cheese, Drew.
I don't care.
Like, anyone finishing that pound of buffalo popcorn chicken? Hang on.
The words you're saying are not making me feel better.
You ate an entire, like, deli cup of cheese. That was, like, one Emperor Scorpion worth of cheese.
You just want to make stuff up.
Let's go, Dan, go buy Emperor Scorpion on Amazon. We'll weigh it.
Let's see how much does an Emperor Scorpion
cost. I would love to buy an Emperor Scorpion.
Hold on.
Give me a moose skin.
We're going to Dr. Amari's to look real fucking classy. When did this happen? Okay.
Emperor. Someone has looked this up before.
Was it me?
No, this auto filled out. How much does an Emperor Scorpion cost?
Man, the internet's smart. Maybe your phone's listening to you. Hey, Nick Valentine.
You
look like a robot in that power armor. Why is he not a romance option, Drew? Drew, tell me.
Who, Nick Valentine?
No, that entire bowl of cheese you ate.
$20.
$3?
It fucked me.
$20 for an Emperor Scorpion. Dr.
Amari? That's amazing.
That doesn't sound right.
What do they eat, or are they food?
I don't know any questions. Just ask at me.
Was that on Etsy?
No.
Did someone fashion that?
Anyone that's interested in mailing us an Emperor Scorpion.
No!
You can't please do label that. It clearly.
You need a dead man. That's fair. We'll have our friends open it as a surprise.
We'll say it's filled with confetti and googly eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Ew.
What?
You don't realize I looked at your cat. Simulators
require living brains to function. Nobody talks to me.
I like your bug eye sunglasses.
Smiley ass fucking Lucy over here.
She's got a whole lot of mouth.
She's got a pompadour on.
Technically, the corpse was defiled already.
Oh, well, spilled milk and all
why
that.
Why is she smiling so much? Is it the dress?
My hair. Secret of the Commonwealth.
Eric actually forced the smile on her when she was built.
My son's missing.
Even when
we shortened her mandible.
Even when she's horrified, she has no choice but to smile.
All right. Remember.
So you're gonna go fire out some buffalo sauce?
I'm gonna pace.
No. He's gonna pee with his butt. Yeah. So he ate like an entire pound of buffalo.
It was like an entire chicken. Let's be honest.
But it was buffaloed.
Yeah. Wait, that's
the hippocampus. Ew. And this thing that little fetus,
little dangly meats. Yeah, those circuits look
awfully familiar. Hmm.
They're not yours, Nick. Don't worry.
They look like my second cousin.
All right.
I'm professional.
Stick him in Nick.
Nick's an older model synth. Is he still compatible?
That's exactly what I was thinking.
I still got a spark in the old carburetor. But even if this works, that was a wandering accent. I'm sorry.
Yeah, why would Nick agree to this? You're talking
about wiring. He's programmed to be helpful.
Don't worry about me, Mari. Let's do it.
He also wants to find the Institute. We should
try. That's true, I guess. First host. But I mean, if someone gave me the option of plugging Drew's brain into my brain to figure out what happened to Drew, I would be all against it.
What if he was dead and we salvaged it from his dead brain?
Then we know the answer to that question already.
What question?
How did Drew die?
I guess we pulled out some of his brain. That's fair.
I
need you to keep
talking to me, Mr. Valentine. I heard that. Changing the cognitive functions
could be dying. So, a lot of flashes. Dan.
Yes, Brian.
You used to wrestle.
Briefly.
We watched wrestling in class today. But, basically, what had happened was the teacher didn't leave any work. And cause she was on a field trip, so she was just like, I don't know, guys, watch a movie. So I was talking to the kids. Everyone that was in theater was on the field trip. Perfect.
it.
So there was five people that couldn't go on the field trip for whatever reason, hanging out in the auditorium where theater would meet. So we were looking around. We had like this huge movie screen projector at the front of the room. And we were looking for a DVD to watch. I found a stack of five WWE DVDs, like Armageddon, Battle Royale.
Were those like the only DVDs?
Royal Rumble. That was the only ones we could find in the room. I checked in the desk, I checked the shelves.
It's really specific to have a stash of in the classroom.
Yeah. And they were all right next to the DVD player. I was like, fine. All right, we're watching Armageddon. I couldn't get the sound to work. So we had Kane versus MVP in a burning wrestling ring. And they're just fighting it out. And it was all completely silent. Except one of the theater kids was playing on the piano. Like honky-tonk tunes. Like
So it was like some vaudevillian performance.
It was just silent wrestling. And people kept walking by, like, the back of the auditorium in the hallway, and they just looked in. And it was just, like, five people watching Kane ripping, like, the turnbuckle cover off, lighting it on fire, and punching a dude. And while this, like, jaunty piano music was playing, and they were just, like, agog, just staring in the room, one of them was like, you're my spirit animal. I was like, thank you. This is what I envisioned for today. I'm glad we got to do this. And we talked about just wrestling.
I was super surprised when I had a random flashback of a career day thing back in my grade school, way back in like first grade. And I only realized like 10, 15 years after the fact that it was actually Mick Foley that had come to my grade school to speak for, like, career day.
Mankind?
Yeah. Except not, like, in that outfit. He was in...
Cactus,
like,
just, Jack?
Yeah, the Cactus Jack gear, pretty much. Just sitting there like, yeah, I've been through some rough shit.
I died once. I fell through a cage when fighting the Undertaker.
I had my teeth out my nose.
Oh, man. He would have good stories to share.
Yeah.
Mick Foley. What a guy. Oh, man. Kane was just really getting into that match, too. He ended up throwing MVP into the fire, and he just held him there until he caught fire and ran around the ring. Kane, you knew who was going to win based on MVP wearing, like, the full, like, wrestler unitard, and Kane just came in a pair of pants. Just no shirt on, not like cut at all, but just that like huge intimidating bulk of a giant.
Yeah.
Because Kane's basically an orc.
Uh-huh.
He's got kind of that round gut, but you know it's just made out of like lead.
Mm-hmm.
And he was just standing in the ring, just breathing like he just ran up a staircase. And he just, like, his eyes weren't focused on anything. He didn't have his mask on. So I didn't know who it was at first, except that he was 8 feet tall. And he just looked dead. Like, his eyes were rolled halfway up into his sockets. His eyebrows were just, like, overshadowing him, like a Easter Island moai. And he just was sneering, like he had just, like, smelled a fart. And I was like, oh, that must be Kane.
Yeah.
We figured it out. But yeah, he held the guy in the fire, and he just took off and ran right to the people with fire extinguishers.
That would be general procedure for being on fire.
Mm-hmm. And we were just making commentary on, like, what's their beef? Why is he fighting this guy? They need a reason.
I hope someone inadvertently slipped into the 1920s radio announcer voice.
They did not.
Oh.
But we were talking about, like, I wonder if gladiators, like, 1,000 years ago had, like, beefs and stories like that. Like, oh, thou hast, you know, besmirched my concubine. I must slay thee. Or whatever. I don't think they said thou.
Especially their own theme songs.
I hope they had theme songs. Like, just that trumpet slave down in the pit next to the lions.
Right, we have to get this one right now.
Yeah, that's right.
Good trumpetus.
Trumpetus. And brassus.
Oh, they're slaves! How much thought do you think they're gonna put into their name?
Trumpet slave.
Yeah.
Did they have trumpets back then?
I don't know.
They had horns, at least.
There's probably some ancient form of the vuvuzela.
Ugh. Gladiators. I want to imagine more gladiator beeps. Let's go bring the microphone up to the bathroom. Hey, Drew!
Drew! He may have died.
Yeah, I think he died.
He just shit his insides outside.
Should we call him?
Yes.
I think his phone's in here. Hang on. See if he silenced his phone.
So if he answers his phone, he can yell at him, and if he doesn't answer his phone, he can yell at him. Eric, what the fuck is happening?
He was playing Grognak for a time. We're investigating Kellogg's memories.
Eric, why are you in the, like, Outsiders domain from Dishonored?
She wasn't soft, but, she loved me in her way. I was such a dummy back then.
That kid has a deep voice.
Yeah, man. Kids grow up fast in the apocalypse.
Dad was either drunk or not around.
Your call has been forwarded to...
Damn, he's not a poop talker. I always answer the phone on the can.
He's either not a poop talker...
Oh, we wanted to
close
talk...
Close that door!
We wanted to talk to you in the bathroom. We wanted to see if you were a poop talker. I was just saying, I always talk to people when they call me when I'm on the can.
Ow.
I love talking to people while I'm taking a dump. I'm talking to you right now. You're happy, but taking a dump.
I feel shitty, but not the poop kind.
It looks
Please
like
don't
you
hit me in the stomach, because I will...
You got, like, a bit of a fur ball on you.
I dropped one of my chicken popcorn chickens.
So just a chicken crater of...
I had a really fat day.
Look at that baby. Listen to that baby talk.
It's gonna be like P.T.
I never deserved it. Oh, I couldn't handle anything jumping out to scare me right now.
The dangerous fear? The dangerous fear parts?
Activate them neurons!
Why are you on them synapses?
To investigate shit about Kellogg.
Why, is Sean Kellogg?
Yeah. Sean!
Oh, you killed Kellogg.
That leather armor. I think this was gonna
end Kellogg. You shot him in the head with a nuke. I remember I saw it.
Yeah, it went well. You thought you could
just Beetleboops. Beetlejuice. Beetlebops.
I swear, I thought I saw one of those have googly eyes for a second.
So you were fighting a guy today, Drew?
Yeah, well, sort of.
A smelly,
just holding pads
guy.
For each other.
So no injuries?
I hurt my wrist a bunch because he kept holding the pad too close to me and I was getting jammed up. It was kind of annoying.
He was a jammy bastard.
Well, I thought you were going to say that you had a fight with someone at your office.
No. No, you'd hear about that in the news.
The booger eater?
Booger eater.
What?
I caught that one guy eating boogers again.
Did you point it out emphatically?
I wish I had.
like a Phoenix Wright character?
Gather round, everyone! Come see the booger eater! That's universal.
Well, there's gotta be some funny way of pointing that out. Like, oh hey, dropped your cornflakes. Yum yum.
No, that's a cup full of boogers.
Oh no, they don't have their faces on.
Oh god, they look like Drew.
Chatter teeth.
Drew, why don't you own lips? Where are your lips, Drew? Oh,
oh, someone busted his jaw.
He looks goofy.
Relied on their sins. Who's this Five Nights at Freddy's motherfucker? The resources I
needed. Bald even at all ages. A kind of random. By robots.
I feel clammy in my hands.
Clammy in your hands.
Did you wash your hands?
I washed them.
Okay. But the
institute. You didn't stick your hands in the toilet, did you?
No.
This is what happens when we overfeed you. We have to learn a valuable lesson. Dan, don't let Drew choose his own food anymore.
Okay.
Oh, look. Hey! Hi! Backup subject. Was a mistake leaving her alive. Is that you?
I understand.
Yeah,
that's Eric.
Lucy, and there's your dead husband, Nathan.
Hi, default.
Yeah. Soft.
Eggheads never liked taking. Time to free everyone else in its memory and run amok.
Did you smell any fun smells today, Drew? Like your smelly opponent that you said smelled like something? They needed something done. And he spit a lot.
Like sweat.
You didn't just smell like sweat, Drew. What did you say before?
Vagina.
You said he smelled like a vagina.
A sweaty vagina?
He fought a vagina today.
I smell like a sweaty vagina.
Oh, Drew.
Drew, this is almost sad.
Drew, do you feel bad about fighting your vagina enemy?
I want to go home.
Drew, you poisoned...
Stop hating me.
You poisoned yourself with chicken. This is all your fault.
Death by buffalo sauce.
Look at that older Sean.
This is very unprofessional, Drew.
He has your hair color.
Quick, steal his comic books.
Yeah.
From a memory. It's okay. Yeah.
You don't have much to make you happy. Better take him.
Not allowed to be happy in this brain.
Drew, what's your favorite wrestling story?
Egwene is...
One time Dan went flying and Zangief'd someone.
Perfect.
Scared the poops out of him.
The guy pooped himself, Dan? The new
breed of synths. I wasn't on the wrestling team in high school for a long time.
You're too big. Get out.
Well, to be honest, like, half the people hated, like, whenever we were practicing, because they couldn't get me in any arm locks.
Because of your double joints?
Dan does not have shoulders so much as ball pin, like, ball pivot.
He's like an action figure.
More than the requisite amount of shoulder.
Yeah.
Ah.
Like, he can scratch his, like, left wrist the hard way. Like, around his back.
What?
Like, he can switch sleeves with his arms without turning his shirt around.
It really makes me think.
No boogering.
It really makes me think how comfortable a straitjacket must be.
Maybe.
Yum, yum. Dr. Brian.
But yeah, so I could never really, like, practice anything because everyone adamantly tried to not be with me. He's like, I can't do it. I can't! And then they called the one coach over, and he's like, what are you talking about? You just gotta try to do this harder. And the guy pushed down all his weight on me, which at the point I was torn, I was bent up, and I was just had all my weight on my neck. So he just, like, throws his entire body weight onto my neck, combined with my own weight. And you just heard this loud, like, explosion of a pop.
Oops, I killed Dan.
And I just kind of, like, as if my body liquefied and just, like, slid out of the grip he had, and I just kind of flattened out on the floor. And the guy just jumped up and, like, just started grabbing himself by the scalp, panicking and freaking out, thinking that he killed me.
You paralyzed Dan.
Little do you know.
He's like, oh my god! Oh my god! Oh, is he okay? Are you okay? I'm like, oh god, leave me alone. Oh, that felt amazing. Just leave me here. I need a minute.
Bring me cake.
That
happens normally.
Teleports.
Oh, I thought they just got struck by Sith lightning.
Oh my god, that felt so good.
I can imagine.
They were killed by Impulse.
Then there was another time when I was practicing with this other guy. And the whole object was we were just doing, like, the grappling. So it was just constantly fighting back and forth to see who could maintain the grapple. And then do some maneuver, you, like, flip their arm up and you pull them down so you knock them on the ground and still control the grapple.
Right.
So this guy was apparently really sweaty.
Yeah, that happens.
Just like Drew's opponents.
I also found out that I would... the way I would just, like, jump and throw myself, I would pretty much would rocket off the ground. So when I flung myself up like I would normally do, the guy was so sweaty that my hands slipped. So instead, I ended up launching myself and, like, completely, like, flat out spinning up. Parallel to the ground for a good, like, 15 feet before just landing on my knees and just getting up and running back over. The coach is like, what the fuck just happened?
Were you a Turkish oil wrestler?
What the fuck? You just made that up.
No, that didn't.
That is not a thing.
Yeah, it is.
That is not a thing. If you wrestle in oil and you happen to be a Turkish man,
don't then Google that. Your phone's going to know and judge you.
Turkish.
Here we go.
Oil. Wrestling.
Ever been in a Turkish prison, Jimmy? Notice how it's not filling it out for you.
It did.
No, it's not. Dan's phone knew he wanted to buy an Emperor Scorpion. Your phone... It's a oil wrestling.
That's because my phone's responsible.
I don't know how to say this. Yagli Guris.
Yagli Guris.
Then there was another time where this other guy I was practicing with, he was very aggressive just trying to push me around backwards. Despite the fact that I was keeping control of the grapple, he was just forcing himself forward constantly. So I kept having to like take a step back, turn around, take a step back. Eventually, I realized that I had backed up. I just heard chuckling, and I managed to like look around and realize where I was, and I had stepped up the wall.
Were you standing perpendicular to the
one guy was standing straight up and I was like this against the wall.
Uh-huh.
And I just started laughing. And he's like, "What the fuck is so funny?" And he looks, sees it, and then I just kick off the wall and push him down.
And Dan is not a small guy. He is our Rubius Hagrid. You have to remember. So when Dan springs off a wall, it's like a building is attacking you.
Yeah, I have a weird dexterity score for as big as I am.
Yeah, like...
like Rufus from Street Fighter. Only not gross.
I should have killed you when you were... Yeah. Hi, Kellogg.
Give us Nick back.
Give him some sarcasm.
I'm gonna have to, learn some grappling. I'm not gonna enjoy it, because that's... As you can tell... I'm very tall and skinny. I'm basically something to wield at another person.
Yeah, you're like a praying mantis. You're not good to bend.
The only way I can deal with people who are good at wrestling is just to kick at them. Like, no, stay away.
And I just fight like a ram. Drew, why are you looking at Grease Wrestling? Oh my god, there's so many shirtless dudes.
Is John Travolta wrestling?
I don't know.
Get out of that closet.
Your Wi-Fi is
I don't want to. Oh, Greeks. Oh, Greece.
Yeah.
Not Greeks.
I got some ouzo for later.
Good job.
Have you ever tried ouzo before, Drew?
Isn't that egg-based?
No, it tastes like licorice.
Yeah.
Oh.
And when you add water or ice to it, it turns like a cloudy color. It's weird.
All right.
It's two clear liquids make a white.
We got the holographic memory time done, so do we want to go find the recon team? Do we want to go to the Glowing Sea? That place is spooky.
Why don't we check out that Lovecraft location that Gekko was telling us about?
Drew, look up where the Lovecraft location is.
Okay. Okay, I think I found it.
No, you haven't, Drew.
You look at a more greasy voice?
Yes, he is.
It's Turkish oil wrestling.
Oh my god!
I'm not bringing a companion though, so it's all me.
I'm a chicken!
Okay. Put your phone away, Drew.
You can.
Tongue
free. I think it might be spookier without.
Spooky. Spooky is a good cat.
Was.
Was.
Spooky.
Pumpkin heard you.
Wait, Spooky's dead?
Yeah, Spooky died.
Spooky died.
Huh.
Spooky got old and incontinent. And then she wanted to sit in my lap, so I was like, okay, just once. Yeah.
And then she died.
And she died right
in
there.
In your lap, Drew?
Right on Drew.
No wonder you have a problem with cats and always asking if they're gonna die.
Yeah, that's also why he can't be a mall Santa.
My dream's crushed.
He has a very specific curse.
Don't ever sit
in
my lap.
Don't sit on Drew's lap.
He's a bird. Bane.
Oh. Unless you're a pretty girl, in which case...
You'll die.
You'll die, but it'll
just
be
like,
worth it.
It says ye. Well, at least you have a ton of fucking ammo on that thing. You're ready. Hey, who's that guy?
Is that Batman?
It looks like he's been
got a broken neck. Hi, Mr.
Hey, Mr. Gutsy!
Splat! Give him the old one, one two, miss a roo. 3-4, miss some more.
Those robots are Dodge Masters.
5-6, miss these dicks.
My eye! Eric.
Yeah.
There you go.
Heal up, Eric.
Yeah, that guy beat you.
How high can those things go?
Mr. Gutsy?
Yeah, what's up?
I guess it's high.
Okay.
Yeah! Fusion core. Yum. I guess you can leave this here for now. I know where this is. This is another place where you get decent armor.
Okay.
Ammo.
What if power armor is dumb?
Why
it better not be.
It's not smart armor. It's not the stealth armor from Fallout 3 that gives you advice and criticizes you backhandedly.
That reminds me of that slingshot in Dark Cloud.
What?
Steve, or whatever it was called.
Dark Cloud Steve? Like Dark Cloud colon Steve? Is that the addition of
No, Dark? No, Dark Cloud is the name of the game.
I'm talking about Steve's colon. I don't think he appreciates it.
Dark. Steve and his colon can suck it!
Well...
BAM!
Just like this blood bug.
Ah, God, Dan hates bugs. Well, it just died.
Steve is a slingshot weapon for Xiao.
Why is it called Steve? Avoid this factory. It's going to lead to a whole thing.
It can be built up to Super Steve.
Super Steve?
Yeah.
God damn it.
And he'd say silly stuff.
Of course he would.
Could it shoot underwater and be Scuba Steve?
Mm-hmm. No.
Oh. Like if you kill a cave bat, he goes, bats are weak, yo.
Referencing Adam Sandler movies.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay. Man, his humor did not age well. All right,
I'm putting it away. All right. Don't nobody touch my fin.
So touch your fins all I want.
Your little
fish.
Little fish. You're corrupting me with your oils.
For what? Grease wrestling?
No.
I thought we were gonna do that, Drew.
No.
What are you, like the interior of a cave system?
Oh god, that would be so awkward to look at. Me just trying to slide out of Dan's grapples.
It would be like in Hellboy 2.
Is that a pool?
When Abe Sapien was wrestling Mr.
Is that
Wing.
A ghoul at the pool? Is this a ghoul pool?
Yeah, this is the Cranberry Ranch or whatever it is.
What the fuck?
Yeah, have you never seen this?
What?
Wow, this place is great.
Get some cranberries.
Yeah, get
some. Make it mine.
Yeah.
I'll get my brick.
Hey, that guy's in a hurry. He's probably worried since you're like roaming around in power armor with a gun out. Like, oh, they're under attack. That's why. I think you lured enemies.
Oopsie doopsie poopsie.
Yeah.
Whoops. Who the fuck is that?
He lured the bandits here. No. Eric, you're like a comet. You're just heralding like doom.
Like a Mad Max?
You're gonna lure them into the buildings now. They're gonna kill all the cranberries.
Everyone's dead.
Don't kill the cranberries.
I hate ginkgo berries. They smell like shit.
What the fuck is it? Ooh.
That's just a gas can of the hose.
Ginkgo trees?
Ginkgo berries. They smell really bad.
Yeah, they smell like doggy doo.
Yeah, I hate
There's
them.
More.
Drew's and they're all over campus. Shooting.
Use your bats. Drew's Use your bats. Like there they are.
If you listen Wait, carefully, I just gave a hint as to where Drew works. They have ginkgo berries.
Ginkgo farm.
Ginkgo tree.
Ooh, you are burning.
Bro, I'm trying to, you know,
lead people on their own witness style puzzle to finding out where you work.
Eric, use your shotgun.
Collect all the black dots, and then you'll find Drew.
These fucking people! Oh my god, they have so much fire to them!
You know, if you can, there we go. As long as you can handle the fire, that's a really effective way to get somebody. Oh god, don't hit me with fire! And then some other guy runs over the baseball bat.
I think he did it. Nope, there's still shooting going on.
Yeah, they're probably raiding the cranberry factory.
Yeah, here they come. I guess you're gonna be their incidental savior. They've been looking at each other for a long time, just waiting for conflict.
Yeah.
There we go.
Shot him in the dick.
Stop shooting on Jessica with my- Oh my god, what are those? Who's that?
Just give all the- Oh, grenades, watch out. Watch your buns. They're still shooting.
Didn't.
Just loot all these guys and give their armor to these cranberry farmers.
If you want to
Use
see
bats.
Dan and Drew oil
Use
bats. Wrestle.
It'll target.
Not Deidre!
If you want to
Not see- the wise man, he's the head of this place.
They're not in range anymore then.
If you want to see- Dan and Drew oil wrestle, don't you?
It should be that way.
If you want to see Dan and Drew oil wrestle.
Drew, if you get into a wrestling match right now, you are going to shit your pants.
Donate $1 million. It took me like 5 minutes to say one fucking line. I hate you guys.
Maybe you should be better at speaking.
I'm speaking normally. Maybe you should be better at not talking over people.
Drew, no one... Deliver a joke.
Okay.
Go ahead, tell your joke.
Okay.
Oh, God!
All right.
You still have enemies.
Here's my joke. Brian.
Oh! Oh!
What?
Oh!
Whoa!
Oh!
Ow!
Hello.
Easy.
Slip on out. You want to see
Dad? You're not covered in oil yet, Drew.
You're just going to push on your poop. Where's your intestines? Where's all that chicken?
You activated my giggles.
I'm pressing on your dooters. Your doo-doo. Ugh.
I got punched in the solar plexus the other day.
How'd that feel?
I collapsed onto the ground in a heap.
See? No one interrupted you for that one. That was a good story.
It's really painful.
Place, did you just try to claim? No, no. Where are you going?
Around this mine.
What's that pile of salt?
This might be it, actually. Oh, that's a mine.
I can't wait to get home later and enjoy a nice pile of salt.
See if you can
salt.
Get it added to your map, at least.
Damn.
Is this all Death Claws?
No.
What?
Actually, maybe this is it?
What's your favorite mineral?
It looks like it could be.
If he gets down to the bottom. There's also a shit ton of bandits here.
Is this where we want to go? Oh. Yep. He's taking his squat.
It's everyone leave a comment about your favorite.
Oh, so this is where Dan, you want him to go this way?
I guess I'll just go home.
Check it out in here, just in case.
So let's check out this mine. We'll do this mine first and figure out what it is. We'll kill some banditos.
What it is?
Yeah, I think this is it.
Heal up.
Because I remember, right on the other side is this huge radiation patch.
Is that where we're going?
Oh, no, I guess we're going to the mine, not the rad patch.
Yeah, so I think this is where you want.
So let's wiggle our way down. Oh, wait, you're in power armor, you can just jump down.
No.
Oh. Yeah, and then they'll all bottleneck, and you'll just shoot them on the same
thing.
What the?
Oh, yeah. Oh, there's one with armor. Yum, 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 yum.
Bang, 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 boom, bang.
I don't like your left arm, because you smell like shit.
Oh, boy. Grenades? Mini nuke?
Time for some fat man!
Throw a grenade. They want a grenade.
Wham!
Nope. Okay.
Uh-oh.
That's going where... Oh, hey!
The dog pound!
What?
Oh, you threw a grenade and accidentally collateraled a bunch of dogs. Oh.
No!
That way the internet can be upset.
Drew, you're terrible.
Yeah.
Buy it faster! They want it!
You got the Zerk!
I made a bunch of swastikas in the witness by accident.
Watch your health, watch your health.
Their head's exposed. Give them a little...
Boom!
Wow!
I didn't like that.
It could have been worse, Drew.
Here we are. Yeah, this is it.
You could have lit someone on fire.
Mm-hmm.
Then they'd scream.
Yeah!
Look at these guys.
They got regular old flesh and blood. Great for
bullets. His leg!
Ugh!
Have some more bullets. Hold on to that for
What are you
me.
Picking up?
A gun.
Ow! You learned something today. Kaboom!
Your head is not bulletproof.
No, my iguana on a stick.
Oh, they're trying to get together.
Don't take her melon. She was
throw some grenades down there. They want them.
It was passed down from generation to generation.
Like the fancy lad snack cakes that have survived for centuries.
Yep. Oh, there's a melon. Who's growing melons? There must be a melon farm somewhere.
You can grow melons.
Yeah, in Sanctuary.
And an iguana farm.
Maybe this your food has been... What? Am I interrupting you?
No, I had an idea. Why don't you finish your thought, though?
What thought?
Brian, let's start our own iguana farm.
I want to make them wrestle.
Yeah, me too.
Kaiju style.
We'll dump a bunch of oil on them.
Back to oil. Always with oil wrestling.
Ahoy.
Ahoy, ahoy.
Ahoy, ahoy.
Do it, Eric. Shoot.
Yeah.
Eric's killed so many people today. Hey, who are you?
Dead.
What, is there a word for that effect where sound interrupts itself?
Oh, their head just fell off!
No. But there could be. Maybe you're describing some sort of sound.
There's a couple of turrets.
I'm sure there's some audio term that some audio-visual person knows. Where it's like clipping on itself. Like when
nice
you were
shot.
On fire. Said true.
Yeah!
Watch your helmet.
This son of a bitch.
I'm sorry for my lack of charisma. I am full of chicken.
At least one full chicken.
At least one. Bah.
Well,
I ate every nugget off its body.
That guy's gone. Oh no, you can loot his chunks. You should go loot that power armor babe too, because she probably has like a good weapon.
That's a good name for a comic or something.
That's the Fallout style calendar.
Tank Girl was the deal.
Yeah, I was thinking of Tank Girl with those weird kangaroo mutants.
Madonna.
The kangaroos.
I forgot about them.
Yeah, they were like Ninja Turtles, but she was peppy. She was zippy.
Yeah,
zip zap map
behind you still.
That's she's her. Like some sort of Harley Quinn.
You didn't get up to. Oh, are you looting these guys now?
I'm just where? Oh, there it is.
Yeah, she's way down. She was your first casualty.
Yeah.
She was an honorable king. She died at the front of her troops. Yum.
She wasn't even scum.
A veteran.
Legendary. Or is that just a super upgraded stick? Hey!
Shadow combat armor. Oh, but that sounds so cool, Eric.
Yeah, well, you don't know.
It's that. Armor for shadow combat.
I want to do that.
Shadow combat.
If I had one ability that didn't involve immortality or something, I want to have a shadow step ability.
Nice! We're right! Ooh, hi.
Dan Bryan.
Yeah.
If you could have one ability from one of your Pathfinder characters, what would it be?
Pathfinder? Are we getting into D&D powers?
D&D, yeah.
My ability to give irresistible commands that people must always obey.
Immortality.
Wow, Dane.
Dane, give me your immortality.
Or teleportation.
And compelled.
Hey!
That's almost as good as your ability to teleport pizzas into people.
That was me and Brian working together, Drew.
Until I could make pizzas that could teleport.
Like some sort of pizza conjunction.
You asked me what powers I wanted. I said either immortality or teleportation. It would really save on travel costs.
This further reinforces Dan's belief that once one magical thing is discovered in this world, all rules are broken, and we can use that one thing to break all rules.
Yes.
That's why we cannot have magic here.
That sounds like a famous theory.
That's Dan's theory of ruining the world.
Magical relativity.
Yeah.
Well, it's also...
Hey,
open it.
It also goes for, like, creatures, too. Well, like, when History Channel put out that bogus mermaid documentary.
Yeah, I liked that one. The Animal Planet, like, mermaids are... I forget the name of it.
Monsters. Whatever it was, they tried to say that mermaids were really discovered as real. And I
believe going, everything they say.
The second that one thing... The door is open for one thing, the door is open. Anything else is effectively eligible to come through.
What about other humans?
Unicorns, werewolves?
We got plenty of them. The second one thing that was described as a mythical creature ends up being a true thing.
You got him.
The possibility for all things that are mythical are there to become true things.
I hope it's a dragon and it lets me ride him.
But that book series was terrible.
Not all dragon riders are terrible. Are you talking about the dragon riders of Pern or Aragon?
Aragon.
I was talking about the Aragon
that
movie.
That movie put me to sleep twice.
That doesn't mean it
could
have been.
I sat through it because I was hoping it would get good. And then it did, and then 2 seconds later the credits rolled.
Yeah, that sounds about right. And then they basically kept playing like the you have god level power arms race. Where, from what I understand, I think this might have been from your complaining
Hello.
Spree, Drew, that basically, like, he becomes the most powerful thing in the world, and then suddenly something more powerful shows up. It's like the Dragon Ball Z
argument.
Yeah. Like, oh, he's the most powerful thing in the galaxy that was foretold in prophecy to become the most powerful thing. Here comes a god.
The problem with the meta story was that the Emperor... was so fucking powerful that if he ever bothered to get off his ass, he could have killed anyone at any point and done anything.
Like the Warhammer series.
Yeah. And then at the end of the series, spoiler alert, he's still more powerful, and then he fucking Ghost Riders him.
And
that's how it ends. He blows himself up because he can't he's forced to feel all of the pain he's caused. He had written himself into a corner.
What a cop out.
Yeah.
I mean, he started writing those books when he's like 17, so it's gonna
be
a
way
like,
to peak when you're young.
It's campy as fuck, but it's alright.
I mean, whatever. He made more money than we did.
Yes, he did.
Shut up.
I hope he makes more books though. I like his writing.
It's not hard to make more money than
turn
True.
On your spotlight.
Hello, Dan.
Bam.
True.
His lights are bright as fuck.
I think the most egregious issue with that movie was that it's a fantasy book, you know?
Yeah.
So you're making a fantasy movie. This came out after Lord of the Rings, mind you. In the movie, they removed the dwarves and elves completely.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Like, oh. So it's just...
So it's like they removed the fantasy from the only part of the appeal.
Cause oh, these fucking raiders.
Without those, like, goofy, unrealistic things, fantasy is mostly soap opera.
Yeah.
Until you get spellcasting.
And war.
Hello. I mean, that's what most things are. I mean, if you added elves and dwarves to World War II, that shit would be epic.
You act like they weren't there. That's why they're all gone now.
Oh!
They agreed to be a part of it, as long as we removed them from the history books.
Hmm. We talked about, like, the occult division of the Nazis, right?
Briefly.
Ah, I love them. They were hunting for all those artifacts and trying to prove that, like, Aryans were, like, the mystical inheritors of mankind or whatever. And they had, who is it? There's that one SS agent who was an archaeologist who was actually Indiana Jones. Uh-huh. And they made him hunt for, the Spear of Destiny.
Hey, level up!
Yeah! Level 3!
Way to jump on that grenade. You're a hero.
Yeah.
Look at that brunette Lucy.
It turned out that the SS officer was also gay, and he had hidden that, like, through the... He was, like... He worked directly for Himmler, I think. Like, the head of the SS.
Yeah, we did talk about this.
About, like, magicians and stuff being in World War II.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen the cartoon Wizards?
Wizards?
No, I'm not familiar with that.
Oh, it's an animated, cartoon that has basically... It's post-apocalyptic future, but it basically retells Nazi history with
wizards
and with John Rhys
Davies. Is this a cartoon or an anime?
Cartoon, like 80s style.
It was just called Wizards.
I believe so.
I need to check this out because Nazi
myself
wizards later, fighting Nazis is like my number one favorite genre.
Is it like that heavy metal animation?
Yeah.
Oh God! It's just gonna be like wizards like standing on mountains,
it's
chucking
not like
lightning.
Gory. It's like almost like He-Man Black Line style animations.
But like the side of like a panel van in the 80s art.
Yeah, look it up on your phone.
I will.
Or is it more like? Yeah, like...
Oh, here's, let's bring this up so people can read the spooky messages.
Oh, that's what this is, apparently.
So we'll make it so we can just, have it, like, oh, people can read it. You need a station 4, we'll explain when you get there. John Hatfield.
No boring machine. How unexciting.
If the upgrade to our new boring machine, station 2 increased 5%.
Reminds you of the boring beetle.
Oh, it just sits there. Steady good quality cuts for the past couple of months. Traffic jam from Station 3. Slow down the output. Station 3. Okay, so this is just like, oh, normal, matter of fact, blah, blah, blah. Safety first. Wear eye protection.
How fucking... Sorry, I know this is out of left field, but my brain did what it does. How fucking excited would you be for Red Dead Redemption 2?
Super fucking excited. We're working in a quarry. That means it could be dangerous.
Thanks, Brian.
Looks like it's unstable, though.
Really fleshed out that conversation.
What power would you want, Drew?
I already said Shadow Step.
Boop, boop. I wasn't paying attention.
Oh. I know. It's because I was talking.
The ability to grant yourself wishes. All
right. That was a high material... that was a high gold cost, Eric.
Yeah.
It's alright. All right. Dan will just edit out everything I say.
You don't say anything when you're busy making, like, cry poops from all the hot food.
Listen.
You eat a lot of hot... Hey, there's a skeleton driving that. When did you get your license?
We'll throw up an annotation.
How'd you die with a cigarette in your mouth?
We have time constraints.
I like this.
I can't time my poor decision-making.
Your bowel movements? You gonna cry poop? You gonna go home cry poop?
His butt's
I hope Dan doesn't edit out all the times I tried to talk and then you just talked right over me.
No, he needs to include those because they are for comedy.
But it's annoying.
Because you try to talk when things are going on?
No, I try to talk at any point, and you do that.
Mm-mm. No, people would just stand up for you in the comments if that was the case. Urgent message!
Not a call to action, anybody.
We need immediately stage four.
That's the same.
Safety first, upcoming events. Yeah, happy hour, annual picnic. Alright.
Everybody panic.
Down the stairs.
Hit that switch. Is that a switch? No. Yeah. Yeah, lights!
I guess I'll put my headphones
back on. Guess you were wrong about lights. Look at this fucking hole.
Yep.
Who makes giant cylindrical holes like this? What is this?
We do in Minecraft.
A giant worm!
Yeah, that is exactly what we do in Minecraft. We always build some ridiculous Khazad-dûm.
You start building, like, we immediately start in survival mode. And you start getting to work on building, like, some kind of strange druidic treehouse.
Yeah.
Like, using actual tree parts instead of, like, wood blocks.
Yeah.
I disappear into, like, a little hill, and then you open a door and see that it's just been bored straight to the core.
Yeah. Yeah, Dan loves the planet core.
I always start by making myself a little cave home.
Bedlam? That person's got a name.
Yeah.
Like an iron forge or something.
Yeah. No! Over the railing. Railings are solid barriers.
He bounced it right off of it.
I know. That person has a 50 cal rifle, though. So watch out.
That'll go right through your armor.
Mm-hmm. Shoot them!
You level up.
Bam! 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 Bam!
Just keep shooting!
Don't ever stop. Just, yeah, rapid fire.
Give her a punch.
Come on, Eric. You can do this. Yeah, Eric! You've been fun! Get that gun.
Give her a smack.
Look around here. Loot that.
Yeah, there you go. Powerful sniper rifle.
Oh my.
Bam. Right. That's the one. I think it's a combat rifle that shoots 50 caliber bullets.
Oh, no, I have one of them already.
Brian.
Oh, okay.
Look around here. I think her journal is here or something.
Can we please do a video of us trying to fight on a bet, like one of those balance beams with those little giant ear Q-tips?
Yeah, they got a little,
the American Gladiator.
Light on.
Yeah.
I'm into it. Hey, this is Skellman! Hey, man.
How I would you? Love to do that.
Oh. Ba-ba-ba-ba. Hey, works, Dave.
It'd actually be pretty easy to take me out because my center of...
comic book!
Masses.
It's true. Despite all of your physical advantages of being fit and active, I would still probably take you right over. One of my superpowers is I cannot be overbalanced. In addition to being able to fit anything inside of any other thing, as well as having amazing time-bending punctuality.
And pizza generation.
I can't generate pizza.
Yes, you can.
Oh, wait, actually, I've done that.
You just have to pay for it.
Yeah. No, I have that other uncanny ability of vanishing without a trace.
Incanny.
Uncanny.
You said uncanny.
Shut up your mouth.
Oh.
And there it is.
But I have... Yeah, here we are. I have that uncanny ability to just vanish and then reappear with pizza, and people are like, did you order pizza? I'm like, I don't know. I found this. All right, we're going to go through the scary door next time on Game Over, guys.
Maybe Drew will get to talk.
Shut up.
Oh.
Drew, what do you want to say? I'm giving you time. I'm in power right now.
Vagina.